What's happening, guys? My name is Bharat Nagpal and you're on Let's Talk Shop. Today we are sitting with a relatively new company. They're not really a new company. They've come back and they've come back with a bang. We're sitting in Motorola's office and I'm here with Amit, who heads the company in India today. We're going to talk about what's happening with the company and we're going to talk some shop. So Amit, are you ready to talk shop?
Thank you very much for being here, and yes.
Okay, let's go ahead. So what do you have on the table right here? You have your three products.
Let's talk
about them first.
So I've got a Moto X, a Moto G and a Moto E here. This is actually a Moto X, a wood paneled one for that. This is what you call a walnut finish.
Right.
This is a Moto G.
Right.
And then this is a Moto E.
Right.
We actually, when we launched in February, we actually launched with a Moto G.
Right.
Followed by a Moto X and then a Moto E.
Moto E.
This was essentially one of our fastest selling smartphones ever, Moto G. And then Moto X, a lot of people know this, how amazing a product this is.
Right.
Really been one of the most innovative products in the last couple of years in this industry.
Right.
And then again, Moto E has been a third paradigm changing product, right? Something that we have been able to bring at a price point that's unheard of in terms of the quality of the build, quality of software experiences, some of these products, right?
Perfect. Now that Motorola is here, are you guys here to stay, or is it like a long-term endeavor with India? Is it a long-term relationship that we'll see now?
I mean, we've always been here to stay. I mean, the gap that a lot of people have talked about usually has been when we were kind of rejigging our strategy and saying what is it that we need to do, right? I mean, bringing about some of these amazing products that we just, you know, that here at the table, right. It takes a lot of work in the background, right?
Right.
The easiest part is selling them, trust me.
Right.
But to kind of conceive these products, to build those products, and that is what the gap was. We were always here in India. So yes, I mean, India is one of fundamentally the most important markets for us,
okay.
Has always been.
Okay.
I mean, with our offices in Bangalore and in Gurgaon here, we are here. I think we want to be a dominating brand in India. There's no doubt about that.
Okay, so it was like the calm before the storm, so to speak. The period in the middle when you said, okay, let's take a break and then let's come back with products that people will love.
Yes, in a way, as I said, because there was never, in a sense, even taking the break, right?
Right.
It was just a stop gap. Let's rethink what is it that we want to do. Let's go back and see what is it that consumers really want, right?
Right.
And that's what it was.
Okay. So Motorola predominantly is sold through an online website called Flipkart in India. So why did you choose to go through that method, or why was that the strategy for these three devices?
I mean, I think if as any company, as a corporation, if you start thinking about what is it that the consumers need, and also what is it that the consumers deserve from a value equation perspective, I think it becomes important that you look at what is it that they really need those products for, but also how do you deliver it to them with the best possible value proposition. So it became a question for us in terms of how can we make sure that there is a standard experience for everyone?
Right.
How can we make sure that people, when they know price, it's that one price, and that's what it is all about. It's not that you're going to get it 500 rupees cheaper at a place and 500 rupees or 1,000 rupees cost there in another place. Also, what is it that will lead them to that best possible price, right? And when we looked at a lot of that stuff, it was from a consumer perspective, Flipkart. But also from a channel strategy perspective, it became Flipkart because it is the largest e-commerce player in India. It also means that if I had to go traditional retail, one, my products will be more expensive. It will take a lot more time to kind of go to every nook and corner of the country. Flipkart makes that sure that we do that ASAP,
okay.
Right? And then also making sure that the consumer experience in terms of our, you know, not only purchasing and maintaining, but also in terms of long-term relationship with them, it's the more one-to-one relationship that you can drive through an e-commerce platform.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I think that makes sense for a lot of people who are online, but what about those people who essentially don't get access to internet or want the phone but can't get it because they're not online, or they don't want to pay online or something like that? I mean, what happens to that? Do you think that market is being neglected, or?
No, I mean, I wouldn't say that market is being neglected. I think a lot of people that we have seen buying are those first time at times internet users as well. There are people who have known the product, who have loved the product, they have read about it, and they have asked other people, hey, help me buy one, even if they have not been themselves internet savvy.
Right.
So there is no neglecting that population as well. But I think the bigger and more important thing is there's a huge set of population which is moving to internet and are much, much more comfortable buying on internet now.
Right.
I mean, what we have accomplished in the last 5-6 months in terms of not only our sales, but also in terms of what people have liked, is pointing out to that e-commerce is here to stay, and it's going to be a significantly larger channel and even growing faster than some of the traditional retail. India is in any case, I think, the fastest growing internet penetration market in APAC.
Right. Right.
So we think more people are getting comfortable buying this. And when you see even the value that we can provide through an e-commerce platform that we probably can't through a traditional retail platform,
right.
Even those people who were a little bit naysayers are getting converted and buying online.
Okay. Another question that a lot of our users have been constantly asking us is that, there's still a little gray area where nobody knows what happens in case of warranties and support, because Flipkart sells it.
Mm-hmm.
And then after the 30-day Flipkart guarantee is over, what does one do? What is the service infrastructure that you guys are setting up?
See, when we sell through Flipkart, we have about 130 plus service centers, which are Motorola service centers. But when we sell through Flipkart, one is that you can go to a Flipkart in that 30-day, almost like a remorse period, and if you don't like the product, if there's an issue, you can kind of mend that out.
Right.
But second is that you can also talk to Motorola contact centers,
right?
That becomes our second line of defense. And then you have Motorola 130 service centers, that's our third line of defense. See, from our perspective, the relationship begins when a consumer buys the phone. It doesn't end there,
okay.
Right? So that's, I think, a defining differentiating point between us and a lot of our competitors. So when you buy my device, I'm very, very keen that we maintain and we manage that relationship and that expectation that you have of a brand such as Motorola.
Right.
And we deliver to you those promises. So we're always gonna have a very, very robust service strategy. You'll always see us being very upfront, very honest, very transparent in terms of delivering our promises. And we're only gonna increase this so that we cover more and more in coming times.
Okay, so Motorola has now launched 3 phones.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen tablets from Motorola in the past, globally, not in India. I don't think
they
made it to India, or maybe they did for a small period of time,
sure.
And then there was that down period for the company. So is the company working, or do you think that that line of thought for the company is no longer there, where they say tablets are not important right now, smartphones are our focus, or what is happening?
So as of today, our primary focus is smartphones. So we're going to be focused on delivering some of the best possible value propositions across the board,
okay.
And across the markets. We still believe that there's a lot of work to be done in that area, right? So in the near future, you'll see us very, very focused on smartphones.
Okay. So smart wearables are the new thing today, and I see that smile on your face. So Motorola has a smartwatch that has been announced globally, the Moto 360 Android Wear device. How important is it for Motorola to bring something like that to India? And do you have one in your office right now?
I think wearable is going to be interesting. It's a still an upcoming market space, and not only in India, across the world, right?
Right.
I think some of the attempts that have been made previously have not been that great, even from consumer's point of view.
Right.
We believe Moto 360 is going to change that.
Okay.
I believe it will be a category setter. It will be a category creator. Across markets.
Okay.
So yes, we're very, very excited about Moto 360.
Okay.
We're looking forward to whenever we introduce that across the globe.
And the second question, do you have one in your office?
No, I don't have one in my office.
Are you sure?
I am totally sure.
Okay. So what happens going forward? I mean, of course, there are rumors of the Moto X Plus One. There are rumors of the next edition of the Moto G. Of course, there is going to be a sequel to your products. Is the strategy now, because the Moto G, when it was launched globally, it came to India slightly late, and with the X, it came almost like a whole cycle late to India. Do you think that now going forward, India will see better response in your next line of products?
I mean, we did launch Moto G and X with a delay of a few months,
right,
compared to the global launches. But if you see Moto E, we were the first country across the globe to launch that device.
Right.
That in itself is a proof enough that we are right up there from a consideration perspective in cooperation. And yes, I think the kind of role that India plays in Motorola's scheme of things, we are going to be right up there with any other market in the world.
Okay. So a lot of new companies have started to come in. A lot of companies have taken in your strategy, sort of. In one of our reviews, we said this company called Xiaomi. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you've heard of them. They pulled a Motorola on Motorola. Mm-hmm. That they used their model, the Flipkart model, and they're selling products. How threatened or how difficult is it for a company like Motorola when something like this happens? Or does it not matter to you guys at all?
I mean, the first thing first, it's an amazing validation of the strategy. It's an amazing validation that you can provide tremendous value to the end consumer. I think that's the most important point, right? In terms of are we threatened by some of this? Absolutely not, right? We are very, very respectful of our competition.
Right.
And that's something that's ingrained in us. Very respectful of competition. We're very humble about that. And it's good, right? It's going to keep us grounded. It's going to make sure that we're focused on delivering value to the consumer.
Right.
See, as long as we are true to our motto of delivering these great products to the end consumer, I think we're going to be fine.
Okay.
And so we welcome anybody, you know, who's joining this space and providing, you know, more choices to the consumer. That's fine.
Okay. There was a recent price drop for the Moto G. Was this the Xiaomi effect, or was it a different strategy that you guys needed to drop the price because the next edition of the Moto G is around the corner? I mean, what was that about?
I mean, I can't give you the exact details, but what I can tell you is that it's not a reaction to anyone.
Okay.
We do not base our pricing and our you know, tactics or strategy in the market basis some of the other people. But it was more a reflection of the August and the buying season and
okay.
The Independence Day time that's in coming up. So we just wanted to have this little surprise out there in the market for some of our consumers, so, and that's about it.
Okay, so it was like a time-based sort of thing.
I mean,
festivities are here, so.
Absolutely. As I said, we love to provide surprises to our consumers. We love to keep our promises, right? We had said that we are going to provide a 4.4.4 and a guaranteed upgrade, but we provided that end of last month, and we keep on saying that, hey, what is it we can do for consumers, right? The problem is, see, when you generally buy a device, it starts degrading.
Right.
And we have a very different strategy. When you buy a Motorola device, you will always keep on upgrading it, right? We keep on adding new features, we keep on adding new software, we keep on adding, you know, giving a new version of an Android. So it's our wish to kind of make sure that we stay engaged with consumers, we keep on giving them surprises. So a lot of this is our engagement policy with the consumers.
Okay, so you heard it right from his mouth. Not threatened by any other brands. In fact, they respect the competition. And we'll continue this conversation right after this. Okay, so we're back and in conversation with Motorola here at Motorola's office in Gurgaon. We've discussed a lot of things, but we've seen that predominantly Motorola has embraced social media this time. And social media is becoming really big in a country like India especially. I mean, it's been big. It's big globally, but India is really picking up on it.
Yep.
How important is it for you guys to like embrace this and continue embracing social media? What is the extent of which you feel that it is important for you guys?
Extremely important. I mean, I think it's about communication, and more the communication, the better the world is. That's by and large the philosophy.
Right.
And we want to reach out to people. We want to make sure that people have direct access to us. So you'll see us, we are fairly active on Twitter, active on Google+, on Facebook. We recently had Motography going on as a contest. So it's something that consciously we're trying to kind of do. It's also something that's connecting a lot of people and providing a view about the company and what we are up, what do we mean out there for consumers,
right,
out there in front of everyone. So yeah, we're really big on that.
Okay, perfect. You've already mentioned the software updates are going to be like a key driver for Motorola, because you say that they're always going to be on the top priority for the company. Android KitKat has almost, I mean, it's on all your devices already. What happens, like Google has teased Android L. We don't know what it's going to be called finally, but are we going to see that come down to all of your lineup of devices, or you have no idea right now, or what?
No, I don't have any exact idea right now.
Okay.
But by and large, our view is that we want to do that, right?
Okay.
At times, it's not entirely possible. It depends on a lot of factors, right? So it's not something that I can comment on right now. But yes, we'd love to have it.
Okay, so like, the thought process has been that as far as the hardware will support it, the software will come through.
I mean, that's generally the case. Okay. I mean, our focus on a limited portfolio also and pure Android experience also helps us kind of do that, right?
Okay.
But I think it's slightly too early. I mean, we don't even know when Android L is going to come, so it's slightly too early.
Okay. So I'm going to come back to our previous question about the Moto 360 because I'm really excited about that product.
Mm-hmm.
So the question then comes down to, you said that India is a fairly important market, even for wearables.
Mm-hmm.
When the Moto 360 finally launches globally,
yep.
How soon do we expect to see it in India?
See, I think we'd want to get it here whenever we launch it.
Okay.
You know, so that's the trust me best answer that I can give you.
Okay. And is the pricing strategy and the sales strategy going to remain the same for Motorola going forward? Are you going to continue Flipkart? Are you planning different things or what's happening? What's in the pipeline?
No, so see, we keep on evaluating, you know, what's the best strategy for the product. So it's a continuous evaluation process. It's not a point in time kind of a thing. So, but yes, our view currently is that whatever we are doing, it's working out well.
Okay.
So in the foreseeable future, I think that's what we'll keep on doing.
Motorola jumped a spot in terms of sales. They replaced a big name in India. Do you guys feel that going forward you would like to continue this momentum, or you don't care about those numbers? Like, there are companies, like I've spoken to people who say that, oh, numbers are really important for us. Motorola, whenever I've spoken to Motorola, they've said that, no, we don't care about the numbers, we care about the experience, we care about the product. So is that your strategy still? Are you happy about the fact that you jumped the number? Or
I think it's important to kind of keep on focusing on the products and the experiences that they deliver.
Right.
If it's a well thought out process, if it's the focus is on the process, you know, the destination is going to take care of itself, right? So, I mean, we didn't care about, as you rightly said, we didn't care about.
I love the way you're smiling and saying we don't care about.
No, I mean, we didn't care about those numbers a while back. If you would have asked us 6 months back when we were starting, we'd still have said that.
Okay.
Today we have a certain number behind us. People have been very, very excited. I can tell you very upfront, we still don't care about those numbers. It's important that we focus on our products. And as long as we keep on doing this, I think numbers will take care of itself.
Okay, perfect. So we are in Motorola's office. A lot of people constantly ask us, what is it like to work in these companies? So what is it like to work in Motorola? What's the atmosphere like? What's the mindset of a person who's working here like?
I'm a Motorola fanboy. Have always been when I wasn't even working with Motorola. You know, there is something about this company, right? From a company that really was the, you know, the innovator and really invented the mobile device itself. There's a huge legacy that we have, right? The company thrives as much on that legacy, as much on innovativeness, as much as on the empowerment. One thing that is starkly different that I've seen at Motorola is the kind of empowerment that as an individual that you get. And the tremendous amount of respect. We have this tremendous ability to kind of disagree with each other and yet have amazingly respectful conversations.
Okay.
And that I think is very, very unique to us as a company. That's very, very unique even in this industry, which is extremely cutthroat. So it's absolutely amazing. You can come down. I mean, I know I can talk about myself, I can talk about my team. We get up in the morning and we know we want to kind of rush, we want to come to office.
Okay.
We know we have an exciting day ahead of us. It's absolutely phenomenal working for this company.
Okay, fantastic. You know, Motorola was then taken over by Google, and then Lenovo took over from Google. So does that sort of deter the company's thought process, the innovation behind the products? I mean, does that affect you guys at all at any level? Or that's just something that happens in the back end, it doesn't really bother the front end of the company?
It kind of probably brews from our basic DNA that we have in the Motorola, right? We're very focused on what we want to deliver, right?
Right.
There are a lot of things that we still need to accomplish, right?
Okay.
So every day we come in and we try to drive those things. I think the whole innovation and the focus on delivering consumer experience is very Motorola, right? So there will be a lot of things that will keep on happening in the background. We know they are important. They're extremely important in our larger context of the corporation. But there is a lot of everyday thing that's important as well. And we keep on running with that. That's how it goes every day.
Okay, perfect. So if somebody just finishes college or has just started his first job and he says that, hey man, I want to be like Amit, I want to be in his position. What is that one message you'd give to those people who say that, okay, what do I need to do to get from where I am to where he is? So what is that one message that you have?
I think it's important to enjoy what you do. I think it's extremely important. if you do not get up in the morning and are not excited about your day ahead, I think it's difficult to kind of, you know, have you know, your shoulders outstretched and say, you know, I'm gonna go and get this. So most important is, I think, to kind of love the everyday of what you're doing. I think that's number one. Number two is make sure that you work with as smart as a bunch of people. Very important, right? For me, that's what Motorola signifies to a large extent. Smart bunch of people, extremely empowering environment, and if you are, once you are there, it just helps you grow as a person. And then when you're focused, you're gonna achieve what you want, or what you're out there to achieve.
Okay, fantastic. So we heard it right there from his mouth, everything all in detail, how the company's run, what the concept behind Motorola is, and what they are going to do going forward. Hopefully we'll get to see their devices right on time, right here in India. So thanks a lot, Amit. Thank you for talking shop with IGN.
Thank you very much.